talking about clear cuts and deer bedding this week on Land Beat. Last time we were here, not quite 2 years ago, we had just had this logged and we used a logger to create a temporary forest opening. But for a deer hunter, we created deer bedding. And if you remember in this location, it's in close proximity to a big food plot. So now we have a big food plot with water holes, fruit trees, switchgrass screens, all kinds of great stuff happening to the north. But the most exciting and the foundation of success on this food plot is the close proximity with bedding. So this was an area, little over an acre and a half, that we basically told the logger, take anything that is of value, and the more you cut in there, the better, minus these two big post oaks. So some people would say this might look more like a seed tree cut, but it's a very open area, lots of sunlight, and therefore, now being into the second growing season, and we burned it just a few months back, you can see the tremendous amount of growth happening, and it's just one step closer to a successful project here on the Woodlands. As we get out here and we're gonna walk around and look at all the different plants that are growing. We have forbs, we have grasses, we have young forest regeneration, we have shrubs, we have briars. There's not many species of plant that we don't have out here, and this is early June. So by August, this is gonna be growing up even thicker. It's gonna be tremendous cover. Right now, it's tremendous fawning cover. It was great brood rearing habitat a month ago when the broods were just, turkey holts were just starting to hatch. This is just an incredible area. And the thing that I love most about this to really show us that we've done great work for wildlife is to pause, listen to the amount of birds that are using this. The amount of birds tell us the amount of insects. So we know that this is a very healthy ecosystem we've created just by using a logger and strategically marking out areas for him to cut hard. I'm just gonna start naming off different species. We got Beggar's Lice or Desmodium. We've got Sassafras Regen, which I'm not incredibly thrilled about, but the deer will certainly eat it until it's out of reach. We've got Common Ragweed. We've got Ironweed. If you look right here, we've got Desmodium and Common Ragweed, and then we've got a mulberry that's growing that's been browsed off almost completely. There's no hardly any more leaves on it. We've got Ironweed, all kinds of stuff. Some of our native, this is a bush clover. Common Ragweed's been browsed right there. We have this persimmon that's grown up. It's several feet tall, so this is a pretty good area if this was needing to be bedding. We've got it right here. We've got mare's tail, which of course is a native species that follows disturbance. So open area that was burned, of course we have mare's tail. I'm not upset about it. Black-eyed Susans, who just come out through here, and the list is endless of all the different species. We have red oak, it's specifically a black oak regenerating. We've got a white oak regenerating right here. Of course, this is great woody browse. You can see some browse that happened this winter and even spring. Now it's got good cover. It's gonna continue growing up. And the plan will be, as this continues to grow up, every 2 to 3 years, we'll send a fire through here and bring everything back down. And if there's any species like sassafras that are kind of sneaking through the cracks of the fire and they're growing up faster, we'll come in here and cut them down. We're trying to keep this in a very manageable state where there's lots of vegetation that provides forage and cover within a deer's reach. It's great nesting on years that we burn it. It's great brood rearing areas, and it's all close proximity to the food plot. Our native Lespediza here, not our non-native Cereza Lespediza, but our native Lespediza. We've got lead plant blooming out here. And then there's also, so we've got the purple bloom of the lead plant, and we also have indigo bush out here blooming. And that may not sound too exciting if you've been around prairie or grassland ecosystems much, but this was closed canopy hardwoods just 3 years ago. just by opening up the landscape or opening up the canopy and allowing this stuff to grow, we're seeing plants that weren't here before, or at least not blooming and growing to this rate. So just opening it up allowed these plants to come out of the seed bank. We didn't reseed any of this with natives. Look at the amount of woodland sunflower over here growing. Just crazy amounts. And of course, pokeweed back here behind me. Multiple sprigs of pokeweed. There's different clumps all around here. This is incredible. Incredible. Goat's rue. You just look at this woodland sunflower here. Almost every single top has been browsed. There is just incredible. The oak sprout right here, the stump sprout, has been browsed. The blackberry sprout has been browsed. There's so much browse here, and we didn't have to pay for it. We actually got paid for this habitat because we had it logged. They paid us for the timber, and we got incredible habitat. This is something that, you know, we can call glass half full, glass half empty. And you see a spot like this, you may, if it's on your own farm, logger got aggressive, and we say, oh my goodness, they destroyed it. Like, it's never going to be the same. I can't make those trees grow back in my lifetime. But if you do it in strategic places, it may not be all bad. And in fact, if you do it correctly, it may be one of the best things to happen on your farm. So working with loggers to improve habitat in strategic locations while logging out the rest of the place can be a great tool, and I encourage many of our landowners that we work with and our consulting company to do the same thing. So we've got great habitat. I don't think, I know the wildlife would prefer this, and obviously they are, over closed canopy hardwoods. One of the final things to note in seeing this is the comparison between going full force and opening up the canopy 100% versus cutting out the midstory or doing a little bit of cutting. Oftentimes I see this with hinge cutting the midstory or only cutting a few of the taller trees, but really just opening the canopy just a little bit. And you're trying to stimulate semi-shade tolerant species or shade tolerant species. And in many instances, we see that being multiflora rose, bush honeysuckle, autumn olive, some of these invasive species, non-native species that have already kind of taken over the understory. So if you're wanting a plant response like this, you have to open up that canopy to really get the sunlight to stimulate that seed bank.